I'm still waiting for somebody to tell me how sitting in your car, sitting in your vehicle with your windows rolled up, I am waiting for somebody to tell me how that is a risk to public health. But nobody could seem to answer that question for me. I got a full breakdown coming for you guys here on this story. Drive-in church services, what is happening? Why are they trying to shut them down? Stick with me, guys. First, do me a big favor. Give this video a like. Let's try to get the likes way up here in this video. If we could do that, share the video across all your platforms. Help me to beat the YouTube algorithms, guys, that push these videos down constantly. Subscribe if you're brand new. And if you guys enjoy my daily video content, would you consider sponsoring my ministry here for $5 a month or more? You could do so by visiting patreon.com/conservativetruth. Just check that pretty link. It's right down there in the description. It takes you right there. You sign up and you have at your fingertips all my bonus material, my podcast where I talk more about sensitive information. I can't break it down here on YouTube. They'd shut me down, guys, because I'm a Christian conservative content creator. They're already demonetizing my videos on a daily basis. So if you guys enjoy the bonus content, Patreon is the place for you. But if you're not really so much, wanting to do that, just by supporting, my channel here for $5 a month, just to be a supporter, it makes a huge difference as well. It helps out with all the demonetization over on YouTube. So thank you so much for that, guys. Like, I'm just a blind fat guy here at the end of the day, but YouTube, they see me as some kind of a threat, okay? I'm just trying to bring you guys the news and events of what's taking place here in the last days. We know Christ is coming back soon, right? Well, it's evident by what we're seeing going on right now. For one church in Canada, Church of God in Aylmer, Ontario, this past Sunday, they held a drive-in church service. These are becoming so popular. We never would have heard of these back in February, right? Drive-in church services. We heard of drive-in, the restaurants, drive-in movie theaters, but drive-in church, it's becoming a thing now where all these cars, they gather together in a parking lot. They tune in on a low power FM dial and they listen to the pastor preach right there in the parking lot. Well, it's about 70 cars show up here. The pastor, Henry Hildebrandt, he's there. He's ready to go. He's preaching, got the people on there. Oh, here come the police. The police show up and they're videotaping the whole service now. Probably not because they were actually interested in what the pastor was saying. Like, oh, yeah, we're going to get a copy of this. We want to watch this later. No, no, no. They were doing this so they could have documented footage to report the church because they, in fact, said they were going to be holding that church, all of the people that were in attendance there in their cars, and the pastor accountable for their actions. That's right. Now, no citations, no tickets, nothing like that were given out that day. However, they are saying that they are reviewing this footage right now. And it may be that they're going to be issuing out that actually what I said, citations, possibly other disciplinary action could come their way, fines, who knows, maybe even jail time. But the word got out that apparently the church was warned on Saturday to no longer hold these style services. Now, the funny thing here is that the pastor, Henry Hildebrandt, had said that previously, I've held these services with no issue at all. In fact, he says, I had the full support of local law enforcement. All of a sudden now, they're changing their tone and they're telling me that I can't have a gathering of more than five people. And then he used the example that I mentioned here at the beginning of this video. The liquor stores are considered essential. That's okay. You can go in there. Of course, you can go to the grocery stores. But being in your car, in your own vehicle, not even with your windows cracked, okay, but having the windows rolled up all the way, listening to a pastor preach from the parking lot is somehow non-essential. Somehow that's a risk to public health. And nobody can figure this out. And again, it's another blatant violation of religious liberty. It's not just happening in Canada. It's happening in the United States. It's happening all over the world. And it has to come to an end. These draconian measures that are being taken against churches and other businesses where these governments are rising up to be these little dictators now and tyrants. It's getting really bad out there. The pastor, to his credit, he said he got that warning the day before the service. He held it anyway. Good for him. I'm proud of what he did. I think we need to continue to do that because these governments, guys, like I said, whether it's Canada, U.S., Australia, wherever you are, they want to take your rights away, especially your religious liberty. They're not going to stop at it either. This is going to be, we're in this for the long haul. Let me tell you that. We are in this for the long haul. But let me know your thoughts on this down below in the comment section. Maybe you yourself have attended one of these drive-in church services. If you have, let me know your experience down below in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I'll be back with more. You guys take care. Please be safe out there. God bless each and every single one of you. And I'll talk with you soon.